familiar day-to-day surroundings. Have you ever felt the need to travel somewhere new? To venture out at your own leisure, setting your course as you go, enjoying the benefits of a free society. To get behind the wheel of an automobile and take the one-way highway out of Squaresville. Danny did. He wanted to leave his usual routine in the rearview mirrors and take a joyride across Highway USA. Of course, if he was going to do this right, there were some things that he would have to do first. Danny knows that it's always good to be prepared. He worked hard. Saved his money. And made sure that his pet was well taken care of. He planned a route based on the places he wanted to visit along the way, but not too specific, because that was all part of the adventure. He made a list of things he would need for the trip. It's good to be organized. Vitamins for proper nutrition. Soap and other hygiene supplies to maintain a neat and clean appearance, prevent any unpleasant odors, and avoid germs that may cause illness. Suitable clothing for every occasion. A home movie camera to share the experience with his friends who have steady jobs. And, of course, the automobile. The cross-country road trip is a time-honored tradition, and Danny needed the right vehicle for the job. It had to be reliable as well as cool. The road can be a lonely place, and Danny knew that he'd have more fun if he had some company to go along with him. Brian is always looking for some action, and he thought it was a swell idea. Even though Brian is different than Danny, they get along anyway and are good friends. Danny thought Rufus would like a change of scenery. He was right. Since Rufus was a stranger, it was important for Danny to know that he could trust him. The gang was all set. Through careful planning, they were buckled in and ready to go, setting out to cruise America's highways, looking for good times, clean fun, and fast kicks.
If I ever catch you doing that again, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to go home to Mother. That's what I'm going to do.
Such a chance in this world, such a mess.
Could have gotten the blowjob for free, but I don't want the blowjob. I want Reiki. I need my energy to be alive.
She kept nagging and nagging.
So what did you do?
So what else could I do? I hauled up and belted her one. That's what I did.
Maybe I should have had me a peanut. Golly.
My father always says, 5 minutes of pleasure for a lifetime of regret.
What are you guys talking about?
Oh, they get their kicks out of tormenting that funny creature with syphilis.
That's horrible. I feel bad. Because we're going to have sex in his bed.
I need you, Priscilla.
No.
All right, if you don't, I'll do something. I'll get drunk and drop out of school.
Let him grow up.
But don't forget, smile. Look natural. Yeah, here he comes.
Oh, excuse me, you got a match?
Sure.
Well, there's all kinds of exciting things going on out there. You're just going to stand by and let them pass you by?
Who the heck wants to live like that? Not me! I'm no screwed-up zombie! Son of a living dad!
Now, let's see. I'll find something. Music to double formula by.
I woke up early and checked out of the motel room just before dawn. When I'd started out on this trip, I never expected to end up on my own, clear on the other side of the country. But then again, nothing really surprised me anymore. Other than the grateful absence of any car trouble, very little had gone as planned. Still, it wasn't until I was alone that I felt completely free. I could now go wherever I wanted to, no one to rush me along or to slow me down. Best of all, I didn't have to worry about losing anyone else along the way.
Among the shadowy reaches of the redwood forests, the annual rainfall is more than 100 inches. The Far West, land of contrasts, typifies the great complex of regions, the United States of America. The moist western slopes of the high snow-capped Sierras furnish water for irrigation when needed in the Great Valley, although there generally is good rainfall.
I decided to stay in that night to try to kick a real nasty cold that I picked up along the way. Despite the many failures and disappointments thus far, this cross-country joyride has been just the kind of adventure that I was craving. Being sicker than a dog has never felt so good. Brian, Rufus, and I left the Washington, D.C. area and headed south on I-95. I've known Brian for a few years now, and he's appeared in some of my earlier home movies. He has a real dramatic flair and is always willing to make certain sacrifices for my art. I first met Rufus at his usual spot out in front of Union Station. It wasn't long after we became friends that I got to know his story. When he was younger, he was drafted into the United States Army and sent off to fight in the Vietnam War. After returning home to D.C., things never got any easier for him, and he's had to overcome some pretty heavy adversities over the years. But despite his extremely hard life and ongoing troubles, he has a good heart, a great sense of humor, and a playful, fun-loving spirit that never ceases to amaze and inspire me.
Get ready. Here comes Rufus and Daniel and Ed and my man here. Here we come. And Lord have mercy, we're gonna have a good time. How you like that? How you like those apples? And by the way, here's my iced tea. Thank you very much. God bless America.
Must be a shindig going on someplace.
Nah, they're just dopes. They think it's Saturday.
Our first destination was Columbia, South Carolina. Everyone was happy to be on the road, but I was especially excited. The Cramps were on tour, and in just a few hours, we'd be seeing them live in the capital city. Brian and Rufus were pretty jazzed, too.
Hey. Let me get it. Wow, how about tonight, baby? Later. Later, please. Love you too, honey. Well, you're having during the day, but you're hell at night. How about that? Love you, honey. And we're on the way. Talk to you tonight. Wow. But we're gonna go have us a good time. We're gonna go see the Cramps. The Cramps. How y'all gonna like that? And boy, oh boy, you think I'm enjoying myself now? Watch this. Wow. Kiss my butt. How about that?